And this Komatsu was in excellent condition. If any Komatsu Z355 should have brought 54,000, which is what I had it at, that one should have. I was willing at the auction to take 33,000 for it. Couldn't get a bid. We got a $20,000 bid. That was the only real bid we got. Well, I had 24,000 in it. I'm not going to sell it for that, especially when Richard Brothers says it's worth 43. So I kept the building. What was unique, after everything's gone, I find out that the dozer is 2 inches shorter than 12 feet and will go into the storage building. It is 1 inch narrower than the door. If I take the little bottom, the outlet, the edging gouges off, or whatever they call them on the dozer plate, I take those off, that dozer will go in my storage building. But I put it inside, because then I can build it to do what I'm supposed to do. And I cannot believe it. I put up 4x8 piece of plywood on each side of the door so that the blade would go through. Drove that thing up there, got out with the cab was close to the door, checked the clearance, and I had 2-3 inches of clearance. I drove it right in there. It fit through that door so tight, you almost had to grease it to get it in there. Why did that particular dozer fit in the building? Why had I not bought one of the D9s at that Fresno auction? It doesn't make any sense, you know? A D9's got more horsepower. It's probably more dependable than a Komatsu. If I'd have bought one of them, I'd have never gotten in that building, because they were much taller than the Komatsu was. So I'm thinking, well, this is good. I get it inside. Now I can build it. Must be what I'm supposed to do.